guys, it has been a hot minute since I have done a face-to-face video. I've been putting up videos, but they've been declutters and plan with me's and just organizational videos where I haven't actually been on camera, and I have missed it. I woke up this morning and I was like, girl, no. Today's video is going to be a favorites video.
My first favorite is this baby. This baby cat right here.
Let's get into the beauty products first, because then I also have a lot of random favorites. My first favorite is the lipstick that I'm wearing right now, which is by NARS, and this is the satin lip pencil in the color Bansar. And I like this because it is a pencil, which means it can be your liner and your lipstick in one. It's super convenient to take in your bag because you don't have like lots of different products. And with red lips, you do have to touch them up throughout the day, more so than like a nude, because I feel like when nude starts wearing off, you can't really tell. So I've been carrying this in my bag. I love it. I like the texture. I like the pigmentation. I think this is a great product. And I have a couple of their other colors in the same product, and I really, really like it. This is definitely a keeper in terms of application, pigmentation, everything. It's definitely a good one. My next favorite is a blush by Urban Decay, and this is in the color Obsessed. I'm wearing it right now. It is a bright, bright pink. I don't normally pair bright pink blushes with red lips. I will do more of a plum like NARS Sin or NARS Douceur. I don't know how to say that word. But I did hot pink today, and I actually like the combination because it's more of like a flushed color, which complements any lip color really. So I went nude on my eyes, I went this color on my cheeks, and red on my lips, and I really like the combination. I think it's really pretty. This blush is beautiful, and I am obsessed with Obsessed. See what I did there? I have a nail polish favorite, and it is China Glaze Shocking Pink. I've been wearing this for the last few weeks. I just keep reapplying it because I like it so much. It is that perfect neon pink color. I just think this is like the best hot pink color ever. I don't have anything on my nails right now because I'm letting them breathe. I can't even remember the last time I didn't have anything on my nails, so I'm giving them a little bit of a break, which is probably super rare in videos to not have anything on my nails. In fact, I don't know if there's any other videos where I'm not wearing anything on my nails, which is a little bit crazy. So, you know, there's a first for everything. But this is a really beautiful color, and yeah. A Honey, I Washed the Kids Solid Shampoo Bar by Lush. This is the most decadent smelling shampoo ever. I am truly in love with it. I feel like I am just going to continue to purchase this. I love the scent. It smells like honey, obviously. If you've smelled Honey, I Washed the Kids soap, then you know it smells exactly the same. And I had a lot of people in my Lush haul ask me how you use solid shampoo bars. So what you do, or what I do rather, is I get it wet in the shower, and then I just rub it on my hair. Like, I literally do like two here, and then like one kind of all over. And then you put it down and you start like sudsing it up, and it lathers so crazy well. Like, I didn't expect, I thought it would be more like a natural shampoo in terms of not really lathering, like being very sulfate free and natural, and like you just kind of have to trust that it's working, which I don't like. I like lots of suds. I want to feel like I am getting my hair clean, and this stuff gives you lots of suds. It smells so good. The smell lasts. It is the best shampoo ever in terms of smell. Oh, I love it so much. I feel like I'm gonna use it for the rest of my life. That's how much I love it. This is like the favoritest of favorites this month. My next favorite is a face product. This is the Sephora Pearl Sleeping Mask. It comes in a little pod that looks like this, and you get a couple of masks per use. Like, I think one pod lasted me maybe 3 face masks. And I was putting it on pretty thick. I was letting it sink in, and then I was putting more on. And this is one where you can actually sleep in it. So it's like a moisturizing overnight treatment. They have lots of different ones. I actually bought a lot of different ones to try, but this is the only one I've tried so far. Maybe I tried one more. I feel like maybe I tried the pomegranate one, or maybe I was deciding between the two. But this is the one that I just really remember loving, and I put it in my empties, and then I was like, no, it needs to be in a favorites because it's really good. This is a mask enriched with natural origin white pearl, which evens out your skin tone, helps minimize irregularities, and stimulates the skin for high luminosity. for skin tone that is even fresher and brighter. It feels incredible, it smells good, it makes your skin feel really good the next day. And what's also cool about this is you don't have to commit to a big size. They're in the checkout line of Sephora where they have all the little extra goodies. They're not very much because they're essentially like a travel size item. And they are really nice. So I'm excited to try all the other ones, but I definitely recommend if you're near Sephora or if you're in Sephora to give one of these a try because they're not expensive and I really think that they're quite nice. So that was that. Next, we're moving on to my random favorites. The first one's a food favorite. This is Bark Thins Snacking Chocolate Blueberry Quinoa with Agave. What? This is so good. I even have Alex eating these, which he's like definitely more of like a legit candy kind of person. Like he wants to eat like Reese's Pieces and Sour Patch Kids and stuff. And I even have turned him onto this because these are so good. They are dark chocolate. They have blueberry pieces in it, which makes it a little bit chewy and a little bit just like, oh, it's so good. It has a little bit of crunch with the quinoa and sweetened with agave. Amazing. I got this at my grocery store. It's not like a special item that you have to buy online or anything like that, but so good. And I kind of want to eat a piece right now, but I'm gonna be good and not do that because I'm gonna eat lunch right after I'm done filming this. My next favorite is, okay, so I'm just gonna self-promote for a second. I started an Etsy sticker shop. I talked about it in my plan with me, but if you want to know more about it, you can definitely follow my planner Instagram, which is at glamplanner. But my new collections that came out, I'm obsessed with, including this one, which is Tribal Chic. So pretty, and I'm so excited because I'm using it in my planner this week, and I just love it so, so much. This one's White Bridal. I have a plan with me on this one, and this is like a little rainbow kit. I also just designed my Thanksgiving kit. It's so cute, and I have a Halloween kit coming out this Friday, I think, and I will announce all of that on Glam Planner's Instagram. So if you want to know anything else about my shop, you can follow that or I will link the shop below. But as of right now, I'm completely sold out and I will be having a sale on Friday. So that's that. The next favorite is my iPhone 6 Plus. This isn't the new like 6S and rose gold that everyone's excited about that I really want, but I actually just bought this month because my other one shattered and it was really sad. And so I upgraded to the 6 Plus and I hated it for the first like 2 days. I thought it was awful. It was way too big. I thought I had like lost all my marbles and made a bad decision. And I ended up really loving it. And now Alex has, he's still using the 5. No, he has the 6. Why does this feel so small? Anyway, every time I pick it up, I'm like, this is the tiniest ancient looking phone. I just love the big one. I'm like never going back. Like I love the big one. So there's that. And then speaking of my phone, I have my other favorite, which is my Audible book. You guys know, obsessed with Audible, and I have a really good one this month. If you saw my last favorites, I talked about Courtney Robertson's, what was it called? Like Bachelor. Peek behind the Bachelor, whatever it was. Oh my gosh, it was so good. So, so, so good. This one was also really good. This one is Holly Madison's Down the Rabbit Hole, and she narrates it, which I think is really cool because, I don't know, if you like watch The Girls Next Door, then you will be more interested in the books. If you haven't, then you probably like don't really care. I don't know, maybe you do. But it's cool to have her reading it because you really feel like you're inside of her head because you know her from the show. You're like familiar with her and her voice and her personality. So it's kind of cool to like have her read it. But anyway, let me pull it up. Oh, the Courtney Robertson book was called I Didn't Come Here to Make Friends. Definitely recommend it. That was the one that I talked about before, but like so, so good if you're a fan of the Bachelor franchise. But Down the Rabbit Hole was another one that it just like sucked me in. I wanted to know everything about the Playboy Mansion and the life there and everything. And it was definitely eye-opening because it was really different than what I thought. But then there were certain things that she exposed that surprised me, but shouldn't have surprised me, but it did. Like the whole thing about how they were initiated by all going into the bedroom. I'm not going to talk details in case you're younger and you don't need to know these things, but there was a scene at the beginning where I'm just like, that happened? Like, what? Like, why would you ever put yourself in that position and then continue?
This is one
That's the cover. It's like hot pink and it has Holly Madison on it. And she talks about her entire experience with living in the Playboy Mansion. Everything. It's actually like a very long book, and she goes into a lot of detail about life in the mansion. She also talks a lot about behind the scenes on the show and also her like New Vegas stint and everything that happened after the Playboy Mansion. It's like more of what happened with her life afterwards as well. But it was interesting. She talks about some of the other members, like the two girls that were also on The Girls Next Door, Bridget and Kendra. And I watched that show back when I was in, was I in high school or college? I might've been in college when that came out. I don't remember. It was a long time ago, but it made me super interested in reading the book and wanting to know all these details. I would recommend it for sure. If you want to listen to it for free, you can go to audible.com/L and get your first book for free. They have tons of books. They have this one. They have the Courtney Robertson I Didn't Come Here to Make Friends Bachelor one, which I definitely, definitely also recommend. And they have my book, Beneath the Glitter by Elle Fowler and Blair Fowler. So if you want to listen to any book for free, you can go to audible.com/L and get your first one for free. But those are two that I definitely recommend. Like whether you listen to it here, whether you go buy the book in like real copy, it's worth reading. You should read it and let me know what you think in a comment below. And then my very last favorite is going to be my TV show favorite, which just ended. It just finaled, and that is Big Brother. I am so sad that it's over, and I'm also kind of upset about who won. Spoiler alert, don't watch the rest of this video if you have not seen it and you want to see it and you don't want to be surprised, or you do want to be surprised. I liked Steve. I think that it was his lifelong dream to win, and I'm very happy for him that that happened for him. But I think that Vanessa deserved to win. She did not need the money. She did not dream of it her entire life, but that girl maneuvered the game. That was her game to win. It was her game. And what kills me is that her win came down to one question, which could have been like a guess on either of their end, one guessed A, one guessed B. They were at a tie up to that point, and she got it wrong, he got it right, he ended up winning, she ended up losing. It just kind of, after an entire game of Vanessa owning that game, like I think she played that game, in my opinion, harder than anyone I've ever seen on that show. And for it to come down to one question, just kind of like, it made me sad because I felt like she needed to be the winner. Like I wanted her to be one of those epic winners that everyone refers back to. And I feel like because she didn't win, she's not gonna have that like fame of being one of the best players ever. And that makes me sad because I think she deserves it. And it just made me a little bit like at the end, even though I'm really happy for Steve, and I think I'm happy that he got that, especially because it was such a dream for him. But I think Vanessa deserved it. And it makes me sad. Anyway, so those are all of my favorites. I had a lot of different favorites and I was like itching to sit down and do it. Like I was so excited. And now it's over and now I'm a little bit sad. That's so sad. But yeah, I will see you guys with my next video, and I hope you guys enjoyed this one, and yeah, okay, bye.